Let me begin by extending a warm welcome to all of you on the occasion of the first of four panel discussions that are taking place this year to commemorate the Harvard Extension School's centennial year. Each symposium will focus on current topics in areas that reflect the Extension School's academic strengths and its core mission. Today's discussion of what it means to offer higher education in a world of ubiquitous connectivity and a knowledge base that is hyperlinked and broadly accessible is particularly apt. Today, approximately 20% of all Harvard Extension courses have an online option, and of the more than 20,000 enrollments during the academic year, nearly one in three of them are in such courses. In fact, with limited advertising, the Harvard Extension School today appears on the very first page of a Google search for distance education. But before we begin, I'd like to say a word about the venue. We are all here in the Lowell Lecture Hall, which was built in 1902 by the architect Guy Lowell, Harvard class of 1892 and a member of Boston's well-known Lowell family. This building was the gift of Professor Abbott Lawrence Lowell, a cousin of Guy Lowell, and was called the New Lecture Hall until it was renamed in A. Lawrence Lowell's honor in 1959. But the building was badly damaged by water after being unoccupied for some 20 years in the latter part of the 20th century. And so with financial support from Harvard's Division of Continuing Education, the Lowell Lecture Hall was restored in 1994. The Lowell family connection continues, however. A. Lawrence Lowell was elected president of Harvard University in 1909 and created University Extension in January 1910 as a bold experiment in what he termed, quote, "a systematic popular education," unquote. His educational vision extended beyond the gates of Harvard Yard, and he affirmed that it, quote, "would seem to be the duty of every institution of learning in this country to use its resources for the benefit of the surrounding community."